bright places. I think there are more rifts back to our world. Can we get to one of them?
Pavlos, by my knee, delivers constant chatter about the honeycomb he found. Phila, little face, serious, tongue stuck out as she draws in the earth with his stick. Hermia catches the boy up in her arms and flashes me a tired smile. I, too, am tired. But I am grateful for this day.
It's a memory, I think.
It is time. I hold her down, stroking her neck. She is oblivious, nuzzling at me. I thank her for her company, for her comfort, for her nourishment. I cut her throat swiftly. She complains, but it does not take long. I catch the blood in a clay pot. She will save us this winter.
Here? This is the place I can help Amari?
Vitae is life against sickness.
What do I have to do?
Create Vitae. Sit. Be healed.
The energy that powered the portal. Right, because that was so easy to find last time. Don't worry, Amari. There must be a way to make it here, or she wouldn't have said it. This looks dead. Needs energy to bring it to life, I think. This doesn't seem to be working. Have I missed something?
The wind howls, but I am warm, cocooned under the blanket by the fire. Her head rests on my shoulder, and I listen as her words flow. Plans, hopes, dreams, fantasies. Everything that we know is impossible, but I know that it doesn't matter, for we will be together, and that is everything.
There's someone in there, still alive.
Fourth rise at the second calling, I, Atharu, make this record. Research into the revised chamber has led to a breakthrough. Introducing the memory capsules allows for a more intense reaction to the pain, rising to a tensor level of 17 immediately. Subjects no longer rapidly burn out. Our supply problem is solved. Direct stimulation of the nerves, followed by a dose of elixir of Emmerich, followed by an application of the subject's own best memories. Or to view it another way, fear, oblivion, hope, fear.
Look at them. I wonder who they were. I need to tell you about Alice, little one. She was your sister. For a while, in our little rooms in Paris, it was just the three of us. She loved stories. And she loved to play in the park. And she... she's with your father now. And you're with me. Oh, and there was Maka, Alice's toy monkey. I've got him here. I'm sure she'd love him to be yours.
Thank you.
I'm not going to leave you. Hello? Can you hear me? I don't know. Grunt or something if you can hear me. Christ. So close, but I can't reach you. Oh, God. Even if you can hear me, I don't know how to get you out. Energy, I think.
amongst rustling grass, up on the hillside above the bay. It is the day after the rain. I can smell the green on the breeze. The skies are blue now, with only wisps of cloud. The bell of the white goat clanks nearby as she rips and chews at leaves. I close my eyes and listen to the world.
God Vitae. These machines, they inflict pain, and Vitae comes out. Oh, little one. That's what I'll have to do if I want to make you better. At least I got to see you. Thank you. see if this thing works. Should I leave without having found some sort of cure?
Sorry.
I didn't do what she asked. I couldn't. Torturing someone for a faint hope. Was I wrong? Will I lose you now? As I lost Alice? Oh God, little one. You can't leave me. You're all I have. It's all right, little one. A rift, a way out of this world. We can use the bracelet to get through here. Come on, open up. How do I get the doors open, obviously? No. Stop, goddamn you, stop! Take us back! Shit! My bracelet. The rift can't be far. Every one of these is a living person. Oh God, no. No. I swear we have no goddamn luck.